everybody, Jill here, and today's topic is going to be the effects that our thoughts, our emotions, and our feelings all have on the structure of water. So Dr. Masaru Emoto from Japan, hence his last name emotion, Emoto, very similar. So what he did is he took water and he exposed it to various words, music, and even prayer. He then froze the water in a cryogenic chamber for 3 hours at 120 degrees Celsius. And I want to show you guys the results from the crystalline structures that had formed. So underneath the microscope, you can see when he exposed it to the word love, thank you, and truth. Now if you're thinking, big deal, who cares? What is this? What am I looking at? Well, I want you to see what happens when you expose it to the words evil, you fool, and you disgust me. For all you skeptics out there, what I'd like for you to try if you have some time, it's called the rice experiment. So you get rice and you take 3 jars and you label the jars however you like. So I, for instance, what I did is I painted on my jars. So this one is love. This one is fear. And here is hate. So just so you can compare the two, here's love and here's hate. And clearly, you can see the discoloration in the hate jar. Now, this has been over the course of a year. I did the science experiment with my daughter. You'll see results after 2 months after trying this yourself. You don't have to paint on it like I did. You can actually just write on a piece of paper and tape the paper on the jar. And if you do end up doing it, please share your results in the comment section down below. Now, looking back at Dr. Emoto's work, look at the water structure prior to prayer and afterwards. Imagine all the people living for today. So regardless if you're religious or not, it's really important to have intent that goes into the food that you're eating or the beverage or whatever it is that you're consuming and you're drinking. I want you to think of your body as the ultimate filtration system. So what you think and feel about your body affects the water molecules, thus affecting your own subatomic particles and atoms and everything within your body. So I use reverse osmosis to filter my drinking water. So guys, this is what I put my water in, these big 1.5 liter Synergy bottles. They're glass. And what I like to do is I like to drop a little crystal inside of it. I don't know if you can see that, it's clear quartz. You guys really don't have to do all that. Again, at the end of the day, it's your own body and the way that you feel that just supersedes and overrides any kind of filtration system. So I don't want you guys to drive yourself insane. But the main point I want you guys to take away from this is that your own thoughts and your feelings are very important. If you think they don't have an effect on your body, they do. Because just as the crystalline structure change, according to Dr. Emoto's work, the same alteration, formation, and structure is the same effect that's gonna have on the formation of your body internally and externally. Here are a couple clips from a documentary about the structure and the effects of water having memory. And for those of you who don't have 1.5 hours to sit down and watch it, I took out the most pertinent information and I pieced it here for you. Please enjoy. And again, thank you all for watching. If you found anything in this video of benefit, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.
Southeast Asia. The year is 1956. The place is a secret military laboratory for developing and producing weapons of mass destruction. Work has been underway here for several years on a powerful new generation of bacteriological weapon. The scientists are discussing what properties this weapon should have at one of their protracted secret meetings. Suddenly, the session breaks off. All of the participants are taken to the hospital with symptoms of severe food poisoning. An investigation into what happened quickly hits a dead end. The scientists had consumed nothing except water from the carafes on their table. The water was tested. No harmful additives were found. Its chemical composition was H2O. And that's what the report said. Poisoning caused by ordinary water.
The American Army uses this water, one atom per 100 million, to kill all the germs in a wound. So the President of the United States uses this water to keep infectious bugs from his hand. So I said, how can this water be?
As it records information, water acquires new properties, yet its chemical composition remains unchanged.
So their theory was the chemical composition of the water is important. Now the sensational news is that that is nonsense. The structure of water is much more important than the chemical composition.
Professor Korotkov's laboratory has conducted numerous experiments on the effect of human emotions on water. A group of people were asked to project onto a flask of water in front of them very positive emotions like love, tenderness, and concern. Then, the flask was replaced with another one, and the people were asked to project emotions of a different type: fear, aggression, hatred.
We have carried out many experiments on the effect that quite diverse factors have on samples of water. Magnetic fields, electrical fields, various objects, and also including a human presence and human emotions. And it became clear that positive and negative human emotions are the strongest element of influence. So love increases water's energy levels and stabilizes the water, while aggressive emotions reduce the energy and make radical changes in the water.
With modern technology, it is possible to structurize water artificially. When seeds were grown under laboratory conditions using this kind of water, the soy sprouts had 6 times greater photon radiation than when ordinary water was used. Using structurized water makes vegetables ripen faster and increases the amount of useful microelements and vegetable proteins severalfold.
If we look at the shoots, the treated ones were long, even, and strong, while the untreated ones were short, thin, and weak. If we look at the plants today, those from the selected seeds have all ripened, but the ones from non-selected seeds have not. We have to say that using structurized water really does affect the growth of vegetables and fruits.
In nature, rivers and streams always flow along a smoothly curving course. But any water supply system has multiple right angle turns. Natural structure of the water breaks down more and more with each such turn.
Water from a water supply system which flows into our homes through pipes has various forms, crystals of various forms, but they are all deformed. That is, it may look like this. It can look like this or have these crystals in many other arrangements, but you won't see any symmetry or beauty.
Water that flows in a floor panel heating system is devitalized and rotten. It sucks energy out of the people, plants, and animals living in that house. It actually steals the energy.